Here at the intermission of McDonald Lauder Group Screaming Eagles Hockey, and I'm now joined by Chris Mooring, who is head scout for the Atlantic Region for International Scouting Service. We have scouts on the program often, people that are scouts for a particular team. In this case, we're talking to somebody who works for an organization that's not a team, of course. Chris, I guess we'll start off. Tell a lot of people listening, what is the ISS? What's the goal of your organization?
We've been around since 02. We watch every level of hockey that's out there, really. We watch, of course, the CHL for the NHL draft. We watch Bantam. I used to do a program with NHLPA for the Mentor Cup. So we used to watch Bantam for that age. Pretty much every major agency out there buys our information. Our company's just not a scouting service any longer. We're owned by Stu Siegel, who used to own the Florida Panthers. He also bought a testing agency, hockey testing agency. He bought a company called RinkNet, who provides a scouting program for 29 of the 30 NHL teams out there. Every NHL team either has some sort of package from us or not. And then we also do a midget draft for the Ontario League and the Quebec Major Junior League. We do a Bantam draft for the Western Hockey League. We're also the official international scouting service for the Quebec Major Junior League. We also do a CHL ranking for the import draft for the Western League and Ontario Leagues as well. I guess we watch pretty much everybody out there.
So now, what would your schedule be like? You're obviously here scouting, but what other levels of hockey would you be watching specifically? Would you be watching Bantam, Midget, etc.?
I watch Bantam. I watch Midget. I watch the CHL. We watch CIS for the European teams, a little bit for the NHL, like minor pro.
Now that's interesting you mentioned that, because a lot of those guys do go over to Europe. That's not something people would think about. Do you think there's a big difference between what you're doing and scouting for a particular team in the NHL? What will be the differences in terms of scouting, do you think?
At each level, for the NHL, let's say, we're always looking at the best player that's on the ice. We do a ranking based on what we think their impact's going to be at the next level. We're watching, which is basically what the NHL is doing as well. They may be looking at specific needs sometimes, but I think most NHL teams are looking at the best player that they think that can be the most impact for them and as an organization. I mean, everything's an asset to an NHL club, and we're basically providing a service for the NHL clubs to have a different opinion on a player and a ranking.
Now, you mentioned scouting as early as Bantam. I remember the Nova Scotia Major Bantam Provincials a few years ago here. Keith Getzen, Evan Fitzpatrick, and Mitchell Baumas were already being watched by scouts. Is that a relatively new thing, watching players that early, or has that always been around?
Well, I think at a Bantam level, there's not a lot of NHL scouts that waste their time. And even for the midget levels, I don't see a lot of NHL scouts out. I think they start when you're looking at the under-17s, the first year of major junior eligibility. They'll have a lot of NHL scouts at the World Under-17 Championships, wherever they're at. There's some NHL scouts that'll go to the under-16s if there's a Canada Games that year. Us as an organization, we watch all of those tournaments. And then we also watch under-16 tournaments, European tournaments, and North American tournaments as well.
I know it's still early in the season, but the Central Scouting released its rankings. Do you have any thoughts thus far on guys in the Atlantic region that are standing out that are NHL draft eligibility this year? Obviously, Pierre-Luc Dubois is one.
Dubois is our second-rated guy as Quebec Major Junior for the NHL draft. The other guy is Julien Gauthier. Gauthier, we hear, have currently ranked in our top 10, and Dubois is in our top 20. They're different players, but they're very good players for this draft.
When you look at scouting, is there a lot of scouting towards the guys that maybe they've passed their first year junior eligibility? You look at a team like Cape Breton, most of the guys are older, but those guys in their second year of eligibility, is there a chance for them to catch the scout's eyes?
Oh, definitely. There's always guys that are developing a little later. Last year was a very deep draft from the Q, and a very deep draft, I think, in the CHL. So there was a lot of players that were maybe passed over that might have been drafted in other years. This year's not a very deep draft on the Q, and I don't think it's a very deep draft across the CHL either. So there'd be a lot of guys that would be looking at guys from last year's draft. They'll definitely get a look later in the rounds.
You mentioned being a service that Quebec League teams subscribe to. What does that draft look like this year? I know it's, again, still early, but do we get the impression it's going to be a strong midget draft come June?
There's definitely some good players down in the Atlantic area, and there's some good players in the Quebec region as well. I watched a little bit of Bantam last year, which would have been the midget players this year, the first year guys. There's a really good player, Anderson McDonald, that's in New Brunswick, playing for St. John. There's another kid, Andrew Coxhead, who's in Halifax. He's another really good player. Both kids are 6 foot plus, can skate. They see the ice really well. Strong kids that can play the game. So they'll be interesting to watch. Plus, there's a kid, McIsaac, a defenseman out of Coal Harbour, who's touted to be one of the top 5 picks in this year's draft. And he's a smart two-way defenseman. Great shot, great hands. It's going to be a player to watch, too.
Well, we look forward to seeing those guys. I'm sure we'll have a chance to see them in the queue down the road. And I'm sure we'll be seeing you at rinks around the league. Thanks for this, Chris. Great insight on all levels of hockey.
Hey, no problem. Thank you.